thousands of troops from a number of European armies carried out a major exercise. While the enemy in this case was fictitious, those leading the charge had a modern opponent in mind, as our defence correspondent Alistair Bunkle reports.
This has been one of the largest military exercises of its kind in Europe. 12,000 troops from 17 countries on land, sea and in the air. The two-week exercise finished on Salisbury Plain in a mock village, only a few miles from the city where Moscow poisoned Sergei and Yulia Skripal.
Very good morning to you from all of our team here in Moscow. You're watching RT International with me, Nikki Aaron. Great to have you with us. Now, first, this hour, the Czech Republic has revealed it made a similar nerve agent to the one used to attack former Russian spy Sergei Skripal and his daughter. The country's president, Miloš Zeman, cited an intelligence report confirming that the poison had been made last year.
Novichok was produced and tested in the Czech Republic. It was a small quantity, though. We know when and we know where it was done. It would be hypocritical to pretend that such a thing never happened.
There is absolutely nothing wrong in us with like-minded nations in our region creating a community that could operate.
The enemy was a made-up one for this exercise, but Russia is the biggest state threat to all of the countries involved here, and European forces these days train with Russia firmly in mind.
British troops stand in defence of those Baltic nations. British troops lead in Estonia. We stand side by side with our NATO allies. If you want to be a member of NATO, you commit to the collective defence of all nations, and that is the strength of NATO.
This is not a NATO exercise. Some of the countries involved aren't even in NATO. It is something called the Joint Expeditionary Force, a group of nine Northern European countries, of which Britain is the largest military player.
For us, we don't really look at who's there. I think the importance is that we tie in together. We all bring capabilities to practice burden sharing. And that's what we've seen here, I think.
All major exercises like this now have a hybrid warfare element to them because Russia has changed the way that modern conflict is fought. If these troops are ever deployed to fight a war, they will need to win the information space as well as the ground and airspace. Alistair Bunkle, Sky News, on Salisbury Plain.